What is going on, everybody? Welcome back. MTG here with another episode. If you're new to the channel, hi there. So today I have right here the Google Pixel 6a and the Samsung Galaxy A53. And I want to talk about both of these devices. They're both priced at $450. And I want to compare the two. I want to share my experiences by using both and which one would I personally recommend to pick up if I were to pay, you know, $450 to pick up a new device. But before I do begin, I want to quickly talk about the wallpaper that you see right here on both the Google Pixel 6a and the Samsung Galaxy A53. This is my latest wallpaper pack. It is called Candy Cane. I'll be leaving a link in the description down below, and there's going to be 12 different wallpapers for this wallpaper pack, a dark and a light mode. So if you want, check it out and support the channel. Link will be in the description down below. Anyway, without further delay, let's dive right in. Okay, so starting off with design, I just want to put it out there. I like the design of the Pixel 6a more than the Galaxy A53. This is more compact than the A53. And I feel Google used a little bit more premium materials. It's got this aluminum railing on the side, very reminiscent of the Pixel 6 and 6 Pro. Those 6 Pros kind of gloss out right here if you do take a look. But nonetheless, I really do like it. I like this camera visor. This just, you know, when you use this phone, you know you're using a Pixel device. It does have a, it doesn't have a glass back, but it does feel premium. When I'm using this device, I feel like I'm not using a $450 device, but more of a $600-$700 device. Like I said, that screen is a little bit more compact, coming at 6.1 inches. When I look at the Galaxy A53, it just doesn't feel premium. I know $450, like you're getting some setbacks. But still, I mean, when I want to compare the two, I have to kind of put it out there. I just don't like the feel, the look of the Galaxy A53. I feel like Samsung did kind of cheap out, especially when it comes to design. They could have went with like the glassic route like they did with the S21 from 2021, but they didn't. It does have thick bezels too, like the Pixel 6a. It does make sense. It's a cheaper device. But overall, I still would probably prefer the design of the Pixel 6a over the Galaxy A53. When we talk about displays, this is where things get a little bit controversial. Pixel 6a comes with a 6.1 inch OLED display coming at 60 hertz, okay? Samsung Galaxy A53, 6.5 inch display with 120 hertz. So there is definitely a, you know, refresh rate difference. However, when I use both of these devices, I don't see the 120 hertz of any use with the Galaxy A53. It feels so slow. It doesn't matter. I don't, for me, the refresh rate doesn't matter. I mean, the iPhone 13 has a 60 hertz refresh rate. The 12 mini that I use has a 60 hertz refresh rate, but it still feels more smoother than the A53 that has a 120 hertz display. I don't like how this is, and this is primarily because of the processor inside and just the internals, and it doesn't make it any faster. It does not feel smooth. It can have 144 hertz if it wanted to, but as long as if it's not optimized, for me, it doesn't feel smooth. However, Pixel 6a, in my use, this, some may agree, some may not, but in my use, 60 hertz has been great on Pixel 6a. I have had no issues, no complaints whatsoever. It's a more compact size, and that's why I would prefer this. I don't really mind that this doesn't have 120 hertz. Would I have liked it? Yes, I would have. But then, you know, what's the point? Because now Google is offering a smartphone with a 60 hertz display, Pixel 6a, 90 hertz Pixel 6, and 120 hertz Pixel 6 Pro. And I think that's not too bad. Maybe when you compare it to its competitors, like the A53 or the Nothing phone or something like that, they do have higher refresh rates. But then again, if you want to compare it to the iPhone SE, $430, that also has a 60 hertz display and an older design. So for me, I don't really, you know, care about that whole issue of, you know, Pixel 6a is 100 or 60 hertz and it's not smooth. For me, it's been smooth and I would definitely recommend it over this. It lags, it's not smooth, it stutters. I don't like it. I really don't like it, and it doesn't make it any better with, you know, bringing the refresh rate down to 60 hertz. So I'd still choose Pixel 6a display over Galaxy A53. That brings me to the software and performance. So right out of the ballpark, software and performance goes to Pixel 6a, hands down. Android 12, right now it's running the Android 13 beta. You're getting 3 years of guaranteed software updates. Galaxy A53 is 4 years. However, if you think about it, it doesn't even run Android 12 that great. 4 years, you don't know how well it's going to be running in the next 4 years. It has like an Exynos 1280 chipset, whereas the Pixel 6a is running Google Tensor. I absolutely love it. I love this material. You on the Pixel 6a would prefer it over the Galaxy A53. And I think performance here is a big thing. Google put in their flagship chipset, the Google Tensor chip, into the Pixel 6a, whereas Samsung didn't even go with like a Snapdragon like 7 Gen 1. They went with an Exynos chipset, which has underperformed in my case, stutters, lags, even when opening apps and starting up the phone. It's just, I just couldn't use it. But with Pixel 6a, it's been awesome. No stutters, no lags, no issues whatsoever with playing games, watching YouTube videos. Granted, it does get a little bit warm to the touch in my case, but that's okay. Like, that's not something that bugs me too much. So software and performance, I would definitely choose Google Pixel 6a. You're getting Android updates on day one, whereas Samsung's been really great with their updates, but you just gotta wait a little bit longer. But overall, if you're going to be buying this device, for many of those, you know, consumers, they're going to be picking up this device to use for the next 3 to 4 years. Which one would you choose? When looking at software and performance, I would choose Pixel 6a all the way. That brings us to the cameras. Now, I'm not no, you know, phone spec guy, and I'm not going to throw out all the specs there and this and that, but I'll be putting up sample photos. And when you look at the daylight photos, they're great. They both perform really well. Samsung, granted, you're gonna get some extra features, but overall, I'd still prefer the shots that were taken on the Pixel 6a. It's just more reliable. I know that when I'm taking my Pixel camera out of my pocket and taking a photo, I know I'm going to rely on it more than I would with Samsung. The shutter lag is there. It's pretty bad. Don't like it. Night photos with night sight on the Pixel 6a, does a really good job, a solid job overall. When it comes to video, they both perform great. Granted, if you're going to just use it for, you know, just social media and, you know, taking some videographic memories, you know, then, you know, they both get the job done. I still prefer to go with Pixel because you just open your camera. Many people just, you know, open their camera app, and they're gonna go into the video, or they're gonna go into the camera mode, take a photo, and that is really it. Not much else, unless you want to dive into the, you know, nitpick and dive into the extra features, then I would say go with the Galaxy A53. But for overall performance in my use case, Pixel 6a has come out on top. Up until now, I think in every single category, I chose Pixel 6a, and that's because I genuinely would choose it over the Galaxy A53. While I do believe both devices are devices that many of us can use, I think Pixel 6a does it better. And when we want to talk about battery life, they both perform great. Neither of them have wireless charging. They both, you know, charge up, not the fastest, but, you know, they're not too bad. But in my overall, you know, day, Galaxy A53 has performed just a little bit better in terms of battery life. Granted, Pixel 6a has lasted me all day. They've both lasted me all day, in fact. But Galaxy A53 just came out a little bit out on top, ending the day with about 25 to 30%, whereas the Pixel 6a ending the day with like 15 to 20, depends on the day. So there is that. If you're a light user and you just use your phone for texting, calling here and there, sending a couple emails, I think Galaxy A53 will definitely last longer, but Pixel 6a will also last. So it's kind of like with battery, which one you prefer to choose, you know, smaller size form factor, Pixel 6a, larger battery, larger phone than Galaxy A53. So I think battery, they both perform really well. That brings me to the price. Now, they're both $449, $450 give or take, and the Galaxy A53 has been out a little bit longer, so you'll be seeing this go out on sale. I do believe Pixel 6a will go on sale too, but you're getting more so similar They're trying to bring out, you know, mid-range performances and this and that, but I think Pixel 6a has, you know, done a much better job, because even though it's $449, it still feels like a premium device. It still feels like their Pixel 6 and 6 Pro, which I do prefer. And I would just put in my $449 and invest it into the Pixel 6a, because great performance, great camera, and great software. I think that's, for me, that's, this would be my pick over the Galaxy A53. And that brings me to my final thoughts. Now, look, I didn't talk about the specs and all of this. I didn't dive into the details. I just shared with you my experiences and my thoughts, my opinions on both of these devices, which one was good for me, which one was not, what I, you know, went through when using both of these devices. And yes, I would choose the Pixel 6a over the Galaxy A53. Neither of these devices are bad devices. Don't get me wrong, Galaxy A53 is not a bad device. It surely is. But I feel like Samsung could have done better with their mid-range device. And I hope they do a much better job and improve this with the Galaxy A54. Maybe just, you know, put out a compact device that's a little bit more powerful. I don't know, using like the Snapdragon 7 Plus Gen 1 or whatever comes out, Snapdragon 7 Gen 2, who knows, but a much more powerful chipset, and, you know, toning it down just a little bit, fixing the camera shutter lag and this and that. And then I would, you know, compare it in a much better way to the Google Pixel 6a. But that's really my experience. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Again, I'll be leaving links in the description down below of the wallpaper pack. It is called Candy Cane. So if you wanna be sure to check it out and support the channel, links will be in the description down below. That's been it for me. I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, be sure to super my that like button, comment down below, and best of all, share this video, because it really does help out the channel a lot and will help push my content out to more people. Anyway, that's been it for me, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode.